Actress Susan Sarandon says she's more afraid of Hillary Clinton than Donald Trump. The Academy Award winner explained on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert why she had to break up with Hillary, her former friend and political ally.
We have this photo, which I believe you actually provided for us. This is you and Hillary Clinton right there.
I know.
You seem very friendly.
Look,
you seem very friendly
and supportive.
Look
how happy we were, and then I had to break up with her.
Why did you... You're such a beautiful couple. Why did you break up?
Well, I told her, don't go in Iraq. I'm very upset about that.
So this is before 2003?
Absolutely. And I said, you know, there's not enough evidence. It's going to... And there's no exit strategy. You know, everything that everybody was saying. And she went in. So I was like, who is this person? I can't trust her. And then she became Secretary of State.
Yes.
I'm an environmentalist. You know, fracking is absolutely the worst thing you could do for the environment. Methane ruins the water. She goes behind my back and she's selling it all over the world.
So she doesn't. So she didn't check in with you? She didn't check in with you when she was Secretary of State?
And Monsanto. I don't want glyphosate in my cereal. She's selling Monsanto.
I'm like, sorry, how can I? What in your cereal?
Roundup.
Roundup.
So I'm like,
I'm Roundup ready, actually. You can spray it down and I'm perfectly fine.
I'm like, well, how can I trust her?
You said on the right side of history, which is interesting to me. I think in certain quarters, there's growing concern that the folks that are into Bernie Sanders have come to despise Hillary Clinton or reject Hillary Clinton, and that should she be the nominee, which is as yet undetermined, they will walk away.
That's a legitimate concern because they're very passionate and very principled. And
but isn't that crazy?
If you
believe in what he believes in?
Yeah, but she doesn't. She's accepted money from all those people. She doesn't even want to fight for a $15 minimum wage. So these are people that have not been, that have not come out before. So why would we think they're going to come out now for her? You know, that's...
You really think that?
I think there's a good possibility. I talk to people who either want to write... I talk to Republicans who have written him in already. You know, and they just feel like she's not authentic, that she's a liar, that they don't trust her. So what difference does it make? You know, if you're a small farmer and you're fracking on your property in Idaho, they just passed a bill where they can frack on private land.
Yeah.
And you know that she's taken money from fracking. Why would you think that that's, she's going to have your back?
Well, because they make the argument that there are all kinds of politicians. Barack Obama is the one that Hillary Clinton cites all the time, who have done things to effectively rein in industries or reform industries that they've taken money from.
I'd like to see that. No, I don't buy it at all because she's been selling fracking all over the world. There's her talking about Monsanto and how clean, not talking about Roundup or what they put in it or what it's done to our economy. And they know that jobs are going out. You know, Bernie doesn't voted against NAFTA, you know, TPP or what, you know, all these things coming up that they know affect their jobs. And she's not on the right side of that. She hasn't voted right. So what would make you think that once she gets in, she's going to suddenly go against the people that have given her millions and millions of dollars? I think that's being incredibly naive and egotistical to think suddenly she's going to see the right, you know.
Right. But isn't the question always in an election about choices, right? I mean, I think a lot of people think to themselves, well, if it's Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton, and I think Bernie Sanders probably would think this.
I think Bernie would probably encourage people because he doesn't have any ego in this thing. But I think a lot of people are sorry. I just can't bring myself to do that.
How about you personally?
I don't know. I'm going to see what happens.
Really?
Really.
I cannot believe that as you're watching the rock,
well, you know,
Donald
some people
Trump
feel Donald as Trump will bring the revolution immediately. If he gets in, then things will really, you know.
Oh, you're saying the Leninist model of heighten the contradictions?
Yeah. Some people feel that.
Don't you think that's dangerous?
I think that what's going on now, if you think that it's pragmatic to shore up the status quo right now, then you're not in touch with the status quo. The status quo is not working, and I think it's dangerous to think that we can continue the way we are with a militarized police force, with privatized, with the death penalty, with a low minimum wage, with threats to women's rights, and think that you can't do something huge to turn that around, because the country is not in good shape. If you're in the middle class, it's disappearing. And you look, if you want to go see Michael Moore's documentary, you'll see it's pretty funny the way they describe it, but you'll see that health care, you know, and education in all these other countries, we've been told for so long that it's impossible. It's like we've been in this bad relationship and now we have to break up with the guy because we realize we're worth it. We should have these things. We have to stop prioritizing war. And I don't like the fact that she talks about Henry Kissinger as being her, you know, go-to guy for and the stuff that's happened in Libya and other things, I don't think is good.